Something's not right. I said, they should be getting back. Mom said, no, they're going to fish till dark. I said, no, Rex told me he'd be in by 6 o'clock.
Kisa Willimon was worried. Her husband Rex and 6 other family members left that morning for a day of fishing off the coast of Charleston, South Carolina. Now it was late and they hadn't returned. That's because 12 hours earlier, they ran into trouble.
Next thing I know, one engine hiccuped and it cut itself off. So I reached down and hit the starter. Clack, clack, clack. Probably 10 seconds later, the water alarm went off. First thing that came to mind was, better start praying. You know, 3 feet of water in the bottom of the boat, there's no stopping it.
Rex put out a mayday call. Then, just minutes later, the boat went down 20 miles from shore. The only thing above water was the bow, which the men and 3 boys used to stay afloat. In just a short time, the elements started taking a toll. The group was also exhausted from swimming because twice the current pulled them from the boat.
I mean, it was hot, right on top of your head. The water was cold. You're getting dehydrated, getting jellyfish stung. Of course, the swimming is just, I mean, it almost kills you, just trying to stay up with the boat.
Meanwhile, the Coast Guard had begun their search, but the mayday Rex put out had been cut short, and they were looking for the boat 2 miles offshore, 18 miles from where the boat went down. They found no sign of Rex and the others and called off the search. As the final hours of daylight came to an end, the group faced more challenges.
When it first started getting dark, you know, I was like, we're gonna spend the night out here. I could feel the sharks. I was either kicking them or they were hitting me, one of the two.
Rex and his brother-in-law were the only ones who saw the sharks, but didn't tell the others. Thankfully, the sharks didn't stick around. At home, Rex's wife, Kisa, called the Coast Guard. They told her about the search earlier in the day and asked her to go to the marina to see if the boat was there. When she saw the slip was empty, she reported it to the Coast Guard. Then she took out her Bible and began to pray.
It was James 1:6. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. And it was like God was telling me, you put your faith in me, I'll get you through anything.
With some additional information from Kisa, the Coast Guard resumed their search. But time was running out. The temperature had dropped, and now they faced the threat of hypothermia.
All night long, we were in the water. I mean, it was so cold, we were shivering. I mean, our teeth were chattering continuously. You know, there ain't nothing you can do. I mean, we would wrap our legs around each other underwater and just huddled up as tight as we could get. But I mean, it's cold.
Friends and family prayed through the night. The stranded group also prayed as they watched Coast Guard choppers search the dark waters. At home, the women knew their prayers had been answered.
And my mom looked at me, she said, we better go get ready. And I said, yeah, they're gonna be calling.
Then, just before sunrise, a spotlight broke the darkness. After 20 hours at sea, the men were rescued.
When they turned around and put the spotlight on us, it was Sunday morning.
Roger, sir, you coming in the land, sir?
Everyone was brought to safety and treated for dehydration and sunburn. Recently, the family came together to remember the events of that weekend, but one mystery remains. How did that 38-foot cabin cruiser stay afloat for 20 hours in 65 feet of water? Rex believes there's only one answer.
Oh, there's an angel sitting underneath the boat. I mean, there's no doubt. Even when they went out to rescue the boat, pull it back in, he hooked to it with his lines and it sank. You know, it was there for the time that God needed to sit there.